So folks, this video is a part of the partnership for this month with Pipedrive. Now we're diving into how to use smart docs in this video. It will be a tutorial on how to use them as demonstrated by the Pipedrive team. Now smart documents are a way to capture and centralize the entire documentation process for sales. So you can send trackable quotes, proposals, and contracts all in one location. You can do things like autofill documents with Pipedrive data, strike the deal much better because you're able to track your documents and see when and how people are accessing them. You can get company-wide documents and template sharing, as well as the ability to access e-signatures too. Now there are Google Drive and OneDrive integrations as well, which work really well. And 95,000 teams around the world are using Pipedrive. You can get our discount below to Pipedrive and check them out in more detail there. But a big thank you for Pipedrive for sponsoring this month on Keep Productive.
With Smart Docs, you'll save valuable time in the negotiation process by creating proposals or quotes directly from the deal detail view. The document will be automatically populated with the relevant deal, contact, or product details from your Pipedrive account. You can then send the document to your customer with a trackable link and get a notification when a potential prospect engages with your documents, just so you'll know exactly when to follow up. Smart Docs Pro is built to take you and your team's productivity to the next level. You'll be able to share document templates with anyone in your team, request e-signatures from your prospects, and remove Pipedrive's branding when sharing documents or requesting those e-signatures. So let's dive in. Now to start creating a document, go to any deals detail page and navigate to the Documents tab to get started. This is the initial setup process that each user is going to have to go through, at least once. You're going to be prompted to connect either a Google Drive or a Microsoft OneDrive or a SharePoint account and grant permissions for Pipedrive to access it. Smart Docs requires one of these integrations to be enabled in order for you to take advantage of these features. Any documents you create are just going to be automatically associated with these cloud-based storage solutions. Now, after you've connected your account, you'll see that you have the option to connect either a personal or a shared drive to your storage location. It's worth mentioning that the shared folder option only appears if you're using a company account where team folders are configured. You may not see this option if you're connecting your private account. You can later also add or disconnect your account by going to the Tools and Integrations section and clicking on Smart Docs. Now, the moment you've successfully connected your account, you can start creating some documents. You have the option to create one directly, but we do recommend that you first start creating a template so that you can use it in the future if this is like some standard document that you're sending on the regular. This really helps you streamline your work and save time. One less repetitive task to worry about, right? Should you already have previously created templates, you can always import those, but you can just create a new one from a blank template, which is what we'll do in this tutorial to better illustrate the process. Once you're inside the template editor, you can update the template's name and also define its category. Definitely recommend you categorize your templates, as obviously it's going to make it a lot easier to find them. You can access a template gallery and then filter all your templates based on these categories. Now inside the template editor, you have the ability to add any Pipedrive deal, contact, product, and time-based fields to fill the content of your template. All custom fields show up here as well. Just copy and paste the desired placeholders into your document, and they'll be auto-magically filled with the corresponding data once you've created your document. These are basically merge fields or merge tags if this is a concept that's more familiar to you. But so when you're finished editing your template, you can close it to save or directly create a new document from this template. Once you've created your document from this template, you'll notice that the previously configured placeholders have been replaced with the actual data from your deal and contacts, right? Spiffy. In this step, you can still make changes to the document. However, the changes will not alter the original template. They're just going to alter this actual document that you're sending here, and that's obviously for the better. Maybe you want to further personalize this. If everything looks good and you're ready to send it to your customer, click on the Share button, and then from here we can choose between a few different options. You can generate a link for sharing, or you can download a PDF copy should you want to share the original file as an attachment. The first option allows you to generate an online read-only link to this document that can be shared with anyone should they have access to it. When generating the link, you have a few useful options here. The Enable Link toggle has been turned on by default, and disabling it will also revoke external access. Additionally, you can also enable the Track Views toggle. When you enable this, you'll receive an email notification once the link has been opened. In here, you have a few different options. You can choose to get an email notification only for the first open, or you can configure it to notify you every single time your customer has opened the document. You can also see that the document has been opened inside of the deal, and you'll also get a notification about it under your sales assistant. Knowing when and how often your document is being viewed can be extremely valuable when negotiating a sale. Well-timed follow-up to address any doubts has the potential to make or break a sale as well. It's all about timing, really. However, we do live in an era where data privacy is rightfully valued, and so please note that tracking views only works with browser cookies, and so whoever opens the link does have the option to not allow this. If that's the case, you won't be able to tell when the document's been opened. When you're ready to share the document, copy the link and share it with your customer via email or through whatever channel you're using to communicate. And on the customer's end, they can view the document and also download the PDF version if they wish. Now on the detail page, a new document will appear in the timeline and a little shared icon will appear to let everybody know that a shareable link has been generated. Below that, we display different versions of the document as it may have been going through some changes during negotiations. It's useful to know that a new version will only appear if you generate a new shareable link. If you just create a new document without generating a sharing link, the document will appear as draft. Maybe you're still working on it and you're not really ready to share it with your prospect yet. Either way, you've got some options. Once your document is ready, you can still generate the link and send it to your customer. The last thing to mention here is that every time you generate a new document, a copy of it will be created in your drive, and when you delete any document from your deal, you'll have the option to keep the copy in your drive intact. But if you wish, you can also choose to delete it from the cloud at the same time. Next up, let's talk about advanced template sharing. This makes it a breeze to standardize your documents across a bigger team and keep everyone on the same page. When creating a document template, you can automatically share the template with other users in Pipedrive. To share a template, just open it and click on the Permissions tab. Then just find a user you want to share the template with and set the permission accordingly. There are two different levels of permissions you can give. The first one kind of only allows you to use the template, and then the second one gives you the full ability to edit or even delete the original template, and it's basically just the same full access that you have. Once a template has been shared with another user, it will show up in the Shared with Me section in the template gallery. Now, please note that administrators of your account can control who is allowed to create templates. There's a permission toggle for that in the settings area. So if you don't seem to see the option to be able to create templates, well, now you know why. Next up, let's talk about e-signatures. Once your document is ready, it's easy to share it with your customers via a shareable link and ask them to sign. You can request a signature from multiple different people all at the same time, so you can easily track the signing process right from inside the deal. Now, the moment you request a signature, an email with detailed instructions to review and sign the document will be sent. When a customer opens the document, they can choose to either accept and sign or decline it. The signing process requires them to type their name, and in the next step, a secure confirmation code is sent to their email address to confirm the signature. Your customer can, of course, choose to decline to sign and may wish to further negotiate the terms. If one of the signers declines to sign, a red Signer Declined badge appears instead. Once the document has been updated, you can resend this request, and if everything looks good, the secure signature can be added. This will put the document back into an in-signing status. If other people in the process have already signed it previously, they will be asked to re-sign it again. When the document has been shared and the signatures are requested, you'll also see the document and the status of the document in your timeline. If the document went through some revisions, you will be able to easily identify which version of the document is in the signing process. We did try to make this visually easy to discern. If, for whatever reason, one of the signers has not reacted to your request, you can have the option to send them a reminder. Chances are they're busy running their business and the original email got buried, so don't take it personally. Just a gentle reminder might be in order. You can manage it all directly within SmartDocs. And just remember you got that good old audit trail to see you whenever the document has been viewed, declined, or signed. If you sent out the request to sign too soon and you need to cancel the process, you can do that here also. An automatic email notification will be sent out to inform people that the signing process has been canceled. However, if everything goes according to the plan and everyone has successfully signed the document, a full audit trail together with the signed document will be sent to all participants' email addresses. You can then download the audit trail and signed documents as a PDF from here. And so finally, all that's left for you to do is to win that deal, eh? And finally, as a cherry on top, since this is SmartDocs Pro, you do get the option to remove Pipedrive's branding when sending documents and requesting e-signatures. So this means that your document is just front and center and there's zero distractions when the prospect is in the middle of making that important decision. To remove Pipedrive's branding, just head on over here and tick this option. And while we're here, you notice several other options, right? You can choose a default storage location for your documents and templates. It's important to note that when creating and sharing templates, it's strongly recommended to set the default storage location to be a team drive location that everyone has access to. And here you can also define which domain addresses your users are allowed to connect with SmartDocs. It could be that your company has really strict requirements on data security, so this enables you to make sure that data is kept confined under your work account only. Any admin can add your company domain here, and all users in your account will only be able to integrate with an account associated with that specific domain. Because, you know, with great power comes great responsibility and all that, right? And so that's SmartDocs Pro, everybody. Try it out today to get your team on the same page and store more information in one place.